We are finishing up example 5 and topic 6.4 and 6.5. I'm sorry if I did not give you enough space for this. See what you can do to squish it in. If not, put a sticky note over the top of it and add some more space. So at time t equals, or what time for t between 0 and 12 does the model predict the number of people in the zoo is at a maximum? Justify your answer. So we know that when we see something like that, we are talking about an absolute maximum of some kind, which means that we need to do a candidate's test, meaning we need a t-chart. But the first thing we know is that we know from earlier in the problem that n of t equals the integral from 0 to t of e of, you could put x there, minus l of x dt. Okay. We have to find our inner candidate. So what we really need is we need to know when the derivative of n of t is equal to 0. So, or when e of t minus l of t is equal to 0. Because remember, the derivative and the integral cancel, this guy gets plopped inside. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and try that on our function here. So I'm just going to go n prime of t because I have it already in there. N, capital N, that is not what I wanted. Capital N prime of t. Actually, and on mine, I need to write type y equals. That's the picky little thing about this one. Now I've got all kinds of craziness up here. I'm going to get rid of my other graphs. And I also want to change my settings so that I make sure I get all the way from 0 to 12. So I'm going to go to 15. All right, so it definitely looks like I have a candidate. I don't want to be beyond 0, so I don't really want anything that way. But I've got one at 0.008 and one at 8.134. So I know those are going to go into my t-chart. Okay, so I've got t and n of t. I know I have to have my endpoint 0 and 12, and then I need to test 0.008 and 8.134. Okay, so I'm going to start with n of 0, which is going to be from 0 to 0 of e of t, e of x, sorry, minus l of x dx. Well, 0 to 0 has got to be 0. Okay. Then I'm going to do n of 0.008, which is going to go from 0 to 0.008 of e of x minus l of x dx. Okay, so I'm just going to use my calculator for that. So I am going to go here, and I'm just going to use this here. Can't I just use that there? Because that is it, right? So I'm going to go 0, or better yet, do this. Do you just do n of 0.008? There we go. Cool. All right, so you got negative 0.002. So this is negative 0.002. Now I'm going to do n of 8.134, which equals 0 to 8.134. of e of x minus l of x dx. Okay, I'm going to use my calculator again. I'm just going to repeat this right here, and I'm going to 8.134. So 281.116. 281.116. And then finally, I have to evaluate at 12. I meant to write n, not e. So n of 12 equals from 0 to 12 of e of x minus l of x dx. So let's put that in. So I'm replacing this with a 12. And we end up with 260.905. So 260.905. We were looking for maximum, right? That's what it said here at the problem. And they wanted the time that we had a maximum. So it definitely looks like this is our biggest maximum value, and it occurred at that time right there. So when you're typing your answers into the homework, those are the values I'm going to look for. I'm only going to check values, but you're going to write out sentences in your written work. So we would say the maximum number of people who are in the park. So that would be the noun, right? Is approximately 281 people, right? Because it would be weird to have 0.116 of a person. People, which occurred at time t equals 8.134 hours. Now, they only actually asked us for this, but it doesn't hurt to include both, so then you cover your bases when you're on the AP test.